Hey guys, I have an impromptu video for you. I am in this Facebook group, Wildlife Science Career Network, had to get the name right. And I saw a post in there that I wanted to respond to, and somebody else commented on my YouTube, one of my YouTube videos that I also want to respond to about this field being competitive. So the first post said, "Honestly, watching this group has me terrified." And it talks about her starting a master's in 2021. Her passion is for bees and pollinators. She's switching her field. It just seems like a very hopeless and unrewarding career. All I ever see is people talk about how they never have any money and they can never get a job. The post that I saw on my YouTube comment was all about, was a particular area of work competitive? I think it was National Park Service. Are jobs in those fields competitive? So what I want to talk about today is not being scared out of your mind to pursue this career if this is really what you want to do. And the advice that I learned from my experience on the job market is not that there are no jobs in wildlife biology or wildlife science. It's that the people that get those jobs are really well suited for those jobs. They have the right experience, the right skills, the right education to get those jobs. They are like a glove. They're a perfect fit. So yes, careers are more competitive now. There are more PhDs, there's more master's students, there's more people graduating with bachelor's. It's all more competitive. But you can get these jobs if you have the right training, if you know your path. That is the key to success in this career. I don't want anyone coming away from these videos thinking I shouldn't go into this career because it's really competitive if it is something that they really want to do. No, you should totally follow what you want to do. But what I find is that people think this career is something and it is actually something else. That was my experience. What I thought a wildlife biologist did before I got my PhD was totally different from the jobs I could get after my PhD or the jobs that were available to me after my PhD. So I think a lot of people have the misconception, and then a lot of people don't know exactly what type of job that they want in the end. And maybe years ago, at least a decade ago, more, you could get your PhD, you could get a master's and qualify for a lot of different types of jobs. But now, with so many more people out there with the same types of experience, they are choosing the people that fits the best. So for this person who is doing the research on pollinators, they can absolutely get a job in pollination science. In fact, there's probably lots of jobs with the USDA, for example, here in the United States. But if you want to switch down the road, that is going to be harder. So my advice always for this channel is to know where you're headed and make sure you get everything you need to set you on the path. For the financial part, yes, wildlife careers do not pay as much as other careers, but if you know where you're going and you don't become overqualified, you don't take more experiences than you need, more education than you need, you are less likely to have financial issues. What I've been doing is writing a book about careers in wildlife biology to help you guys with all of this. But I also thought people needed more self-reflection and they needed to be taught exactly how to know what you want to do and how to find those jobs. So I started creating a workbook and I created all these different exercises, but I really want to see those in action, and I thought it would be even better if I could talk to you directly about those exercises and get your feedback. So that is exactly what I'm doing. I am creating a beta group for my group. I'm calling it Confusion to Clarity, and the idea is that you will come into this program with so many questions about what to do next. You don't know where you want to go in this career. You know you want to be a wildlife biologist, but you don't know how to get there. And when you come out of this group, you are going to have a roadmap that tells you what you need to get that career. So if you're somebody who's really confused in this career, you have a lot of questions, you don't know what to do next, then this is the group for you. We are gonna start July 20th, so I'm gonna put a link below. on how you can sign up and get more information, but I think this is going to be really fun. I'm going to use all of my experiences from my 17 years of being in this field. I've been on the job market for a long time too, so I know what's out there. I know your struggles. I've been exactly in your place. I know your confusion. And I know I can most certainly help you get some clarity from all of the problems that you are having with this career. And I will tell you, I Google wildlife biology careers a lot because I like to see where my blog posts are ranking, and I read a lot of the blog posts. So many of them are so wrong. What a wildlife biologist does, what they say wildlife biologist does, is not what we do. So I hope you will join me, a real wildlife biologist, and get some clarity in your careers. Thank you guys so much, and you can do it. If you want to become a wildlife biologist, you absolutely can do it. You just gotta have a better strategy. Bye.